analyze the following beam. By flexibility matrix method. Given beam is like this. Support is simply supported. Hinged support like this. Then it is roller. Then again two rollers here. Then again here roller. Spans are like this. This is 12 meters, this is 4 meter and this is 8 meter, again this is 12 meter. In UDL, here 40 kN per meter, this UDL 20 kN per meter and here point load 120 kilonewtons like this. First, this solution, degree of static inertia is here 5 reactions are there, so 5 minus 3 equilibrium conditions, so 2 is the static inertia. That means 2 redundants are there. We should remove 2 supports, or we should remove, I mean, we can make the supports, we can make beam, we can insert the hinge, or we can release the moment, support moments. That is to make determinate this beam can be converted to like this. This support is there, here one support. Here on support, here on support. Release this moment, internal moment, like this. That means it becomes hinge here. So this is coordinate 1. And release this moment also. This is coordinate 2. So after releasing the this becomes a that means releasing means introduction of a hinge at that support, internal hinge at that support. Now after releasing this structure, then we will find delta 1L, delta 2L. First one, delta 1L equal to delta 1L is displacement, at coordinate 1, due to external loading in released structure. That is in this beam, we are applying external loads. See, release structure means this becomes hinge. So after releasing the moments, this becomes hinge and this becomes hinge, internal hinge. Internal hinge. Now these are the loads. This is 40 kN per meter. This is 20 kN per meter. And here point load. 120 kN. Meter, 4 meter, 8 meter, 12 meter. So at coordinate 1, due to external load, what is the displacement? So that we will see. So it means it displaces like this, displaces like this, displaces like this. At this one, let us take this is theta 1, this is theta 2. So delta 1 L is theta 1 plus theta 2. Theta 1, we know, due to UDL, theta 1 is W L square by W L square by 48 EI. Or otherwise, we can take, we can go for, to find theta 1, theta 2, we can go for conjugate beam method, that is in conjugate beam method Penaumont diagram is like this and simply support beam. So suppose this is WL square by 8. In conjugate beam the Penaumont diagram becomes when M by EA becomes curvature, curvature becomes loading for conjugate beam, and here this reaction will be now slope at theta 1, slope at, I mean the reaction becomes theta 1. Here WL square by 8 means 40 into, this is 12 meters, here 40 into L square, 12 square by 8 EA. This mid ordinate, that equal to 40 into 12 square divided by 12 square divided by 8, 720 EI, 720 by EI. Now this reaction is total load is 2/3 of base 12 meters into 720 by EI into half, because half only this reaction, this RB. This is RB, that is nothing but theta 1 equal to, which is equal to 1 by 2 into 2/3 of base 12 into 720 equal to 2880 by EA, that is theta 1. And theta 2, for theta 2 is like this, the bend moment is like this. That is WAB by L, that is 120 into 4 into 8 by L 12 EA. This is maximum ordinate and this is the loading in conjugate beam. Now this reaction, this reaction is now theta 2. Theta 2 is this reaction, that equal to taking moment about B, taking moments about right support, take moments about, suppose this is B, this is C, about C, RB into 12 meters, this is 4, this is 8, RB into 12 equal to half into 8 into, this is basically 120 into 4 into 8 divided by 12, that is 320 by A. That height is 320 by A. So half into 8 into 320 by A into 2/3 of 8 plus half into 4 into 320 by A into 8 plus 4 by 3. Therefore, RB equal to 0.5 into 8 into 320 into 16 divided by 3 plus 0.5 into 4 into 320 into 8 plus 4 by 3. 4 by 3, 8 plus 4 by 3 equal to divided by 12. That is, by 3 EA, which is equal to theta 2. This is theta 2. Theta 2 equal to RB. Now delta 1 L equal to theta 1 is 2880 by EA plus theta 2 is 3200 by 3 EA, which is equal to 11840 by 3 EA. That is delta 1 L. Similarly, we can find delta 2 L. Delta 2L equal to displacement. Displacement at coordinate. Coordinate 2 due to external loading. In the released structure. So structure is like this. Here UDL 20 kilonewton per meter here. Here 40 kilonewton per meter, a point load here 120 kilonewton. This is 12 meter, 4 meter, 8 meter, and this is 12 meter. Now, this is released structure, means here hinge. We will make it hinge here and make it hinge here. Then it becomes determinate, statically determinate one. Now it deforms like this. That means here, let us take, this is theta 3 and this is theta 4. Then theta 3 and theta 4 we need to find. So for that, see here, bending moment diagram for this is like this, that by EA becomes curvature diagram, and this one the Venn diagram is like this. Now here it is WAB by L, that is 120 into 4 into 8 by 12 EI. 120 into 4 into 8 divided by 12. 320 by EI. Here WL square by 8, 20 into L square, 12 square by 8. 20 into 12 square divided by 8. 360 by A. Now this reaction, let us take this is let us take it is R1, this is R2. Then R1 is taking moments about left support, that is this is 4 meters, this is 8 meters. R1 into 12 equal to about left support, half into 4 into 320 by EI plus into half into 4 into 320 by EI into 4 by 3 plus half into 8 into 320 by EI into 4 plus 8 by 3. Therefore, the theta 3 is nothing but R1, that equal to 1 by 2 into 4 into 320 into 4 by 3 plus half into 8, that means 4 into 320 into 4 plus 8 by 3 equal to divided by 12. That is 0.5 into 4 into 320 into 4 by 3. So it is not 4 by 3, 2/3 of 4, because the centroid is 2/3 of 4 about left support, that means 8 by 3, 8 by 3 plus 4 into half into 8 into 320 into 4 plus 8 by 3 divided by 12, 2560 by 3 EA, theta 3, and theta 4 is here. Total load by 2, that means half into 2/3 of base 12 meters into height 360 by EI, which is equal to half into 2 by 3 into 12 into 360, 1440 by EI. So that is nothing but delta 2L is nothing but theta 3 plus theta 4, that equal to 2560 by 3 EI plus 1440 by EI, which is equal to 6880 by 3 EI, that is delta 2L. Then flexibility matrix will develop. Flexibility matrix. Flexibility matrix. For this, first we will see delta 1 1. Delta 1 1. Displacement at coordinate 1 due to load at coordinate 1, that is in the religious structure. In religious structure. Here we have released these moments, that means we introduced a hinge here, internal hinge. If you apply a unit moment here like this at coordinate 1, what is the displacement at this point? That means here, this one you will see. This is theta 1, this is theta 2, that we need to find. By applying unit moment, what is the displacement? That equal to theta 1 plus theta 2, as shown in the figure. Unit moment is applied here. Unit moment, internal moment is applied here. So what is the theta 1, what is theta 2? This is 12 meters. This is 12 meters. That is, by conjugate beam method, we can solve this very easily. That is, moment diagram is from right side anticlockwise. It is the conjugate beam having load like this, one unit load, 1 by EA. 1 by EA is the moment, support reaction. So taking a moment support left end, let's take this is R1. So this is 12 meters. R1 into R1 into 12 equal to half into 12 meters into 1 by EI into 2/3 of 12. Therefore, R1 equal to 12 by 3 EI. 12 by 3 EI, which is nothing but theta 1. Similarly, this span also, applying moment here, it is like this. Conjugate beam load is like this. This is 1 by EI. This is also 12 meters. These are the reactions. Let us take this is R2. So by symmetry also we can tell. So theta 2 equal to R2. That is nothing but 12 by 3 EI. So theta 1, theta 2 equal to 12 by 3a plus 12 by 3a, that equal to 8 by a is the delta 11 element. Similarly, we will find delta 12 element. Delta 12 equal to displacement at 1 due to unit load. Here unit load. Due to unit load at 2, coordinate 2, in released structure. In released structure. That is, let us take this is the structure, released structure. Releases are these hinges, internal hinges. We are applying unit load at coordinate 2 like this, one unit moment. Now what is the slope here in the coordinate 1 direction? That is theta, that is delta 12. So here this is the conjugate beam. This is 1 by EI, this is 12, this is the load actually, this is the reaction. So theta equal to R actually, first we will find R into 12 equal to half into 12 into 1 by EI into 1/3 of 12. Therefore theta equal to, it is nothing but R, which is equal to theta equal to R, which is equal to total cancel, 2 cancel, 1 by 2 cancel, total cancel, 2 and 6, 6 times, 6 by 3, 2 by A, 2 by A is the theta, so that is 2 by A, theta 1, 2, so theta 2, 1, delta 1, 2, delta 2, 1 also, delta 2, 1 also equal to delta 1, 2, which is equal to 2 by A, 2 by A, then we will see delta 2, 2, delta 2 2 equal to displacement at 2 due to unit load at 2 in released structure. Released structure. That is this is the released structure. After introducing this hinges, it becomes released, and we are applying unit couple at unit moment, internal moment at 1. So what is the internal, I mean this rotation, displacement? Let us take this is theta 1, this is theta 2. So theta 1, theta 2. Now you can take conjugate beam method. It is like this. This is 1 by A. 12 meters. Right side also it is like this. This span also 12 meters. This also 1 by A height. So these reactions are, let us take this is R1, this is R2. So R1 into 12 equal to half into 12 into 1 by A into 2/3 of 12, or R1 is nothing but theta 1, R1 equal to 12, 12 cancel, 2 cancel, 12 by 3, that is 4 by A. Similarly, R2 into 12 equal to half into 12 into 1 by A into 2/3 of 12. So this theta 2 equal to R2 equal to 4 by A. So delta 2 equal to theta 1 plus theta 2, that is 4A plus 4A, that equal to 8 by A. So this is the flexibility matrix. Now P1 P2 equal to formula delta 1 1 delta 1 2 delta 2 1 delta 2 2 inverse into delta 1 delta 2 at any displacements are there at coordinates, that is delta 1 delta 2 and delta 1L delta 2L, that equal to delta 1 1 is 8 by A, delta 1 2 is 2 by A, this also 2 by A, again this is 8 by A inverse. Here delta 1 delta 2 initial and end displacements are there, then it will be there. Here initial displacements are not there at coordinates. So 0 0 delta 1 L is 11,000 840 by 3 EI. Delta 2L is 6880 by 3 EI, which is equal to inverse is 1 by AD minus BC, 1 by AD 64 by EI whole square minus 4 by EI whole square into DA 8 by EI, 8 by EI minus B minus 2 by EI, minus 2 by EI into minus 11,840 by 3 EI minus 6,880 by 3 EI, which is equal to EI square 1 by A, 1 by A will get cancelled. So this becomes 1 by 60 into 8 minus 2 minus 2 8 into minus 11,840 by 3 minus 6,880 by 3, which is equal to 8 into minus 11,840 by 3 plus 2 into 6880 by 3 divided by 60. Eight into eight into 11,840 by 3, which is minus 2 into 6,880 by 3 by 60 minus 450, approximately minus 450. And one more thing, minus 2 into minus minus plus 2 into 11,840 by 3 minus 8 into 6,880 by 3 by 60, that is minus 174 minus 174 kilonewton meter. So that is P1 P2. That means results are like this. In the released structure, at coordinate 1 we got 450, minus 450. That means, see, these are the external loads. This is 40 kilonewton per meter and this UDL is 20 kilonewton per meter and here point load is 120 kilonewton. See, here we assumed at this support clockwise, but we got negative, so it is 450 and this is 450 minus. Similarly, here also this is 174 and this is 174 moment, kilonewton meters moment. So with that we can find reactions here. This reaction will be, this is 12 meters, suppose this is RA, RA, this is RD. Okay, now this reaction is now RB dash and this is RB double dash. here reactions RC dash, and here reaction from this side RC double dash. Now we can find reactions here. RA, you see, take moments this side about right of the span, or otherwise left side. See here, it is like this. 40 kilonewton per meter, and this is 450. See here, 12 meters. Now this can be analyzed like this. Due to 40 into 12, 480, that means 240, and 450 by 12, that is 37.5. To make it anti-clockwise, it is like this. 37.5 is 450 by 12. Now 240 minus 37.5 is the RA, 202.5. This RB dash is 240 plus 37.5, 277.5. This one is RB double dash, we can find. This one 120, this way it is 450, and this way it is 174. For 120, it is this side 80 and this side 40, because it is 1:2 ratio. This is 4 meters and 8 meters. And due to moments, an imbalancing moment is anti-clockwise, that means clockwise couples like this, it will come. 450 minus 174, 276 by 12, 23 here. Similarly, here this 20 kilonewtons per meter is there, like that 12 meter span. So 240 total load, so 120 and 120, and this moment 174 by 12, that is 14.5. anti-clockwise means, to make it clockwise, 14.5, that means 20 minus 40, 120 minus 14.5, that is 105.5. RC dash equal to 120 plus 14.5, 134.5. RC double dash, RC dash equal to 140 minus 23, 40 minus 23, 17. So RB dash 80 plus 23, 103. So final reactions are like this. Kilonewton per meter, 120 kilonewtons, 20 kilonewton per meter. This reaction is 202.5. This reaction is summation of RB dash and RB double dash, 277.5 plus 103, 380.5. Then 17 plus 134.5, that is 151.5. Last one is 105.5. Now shear force diagram is like this. Up 202.5, then 40 into 12. 40 into 12, 480. Means comes here. Then up and right, then down, and right, then up, and inclined like this, then here. So values are, this is 202.5 minus 40 into 12, that is minus 277.5 plus 380.5, that is 103 minus 120 minus 17 plus 151.5 134.5 plus 134.5 minus 20 into 12 minus 105.5 and it becomes 0 here. Minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, plus. This is the shear force diagram. Similarly, bending moment diagram is shape is like this, 277.5. Bending moment diagram, it starts with 0 here, it is positive and get maximum here and the moment of hogging, that means negative here, because it goes like this, because its maximum here somewhere and it gets negative, that is 450 here moment, and then straight 450 minus 450 plus 103 into 4 minus 38, so it will be negative side only, it is like this, and again decreases minus 17 into 8 minus 174 minus 174, this is minus minus 174, negative side only, negative moment only. Then this distance is about, this one is actually, this distance you can find, this distance, that is 134.5 divided by 134.5 plus 105.5 into 12, the distance is 6.725. So maximum is here minus 174 plus 0.5 into 134.5 into 6.725. It is positive, it goes positive like this and it becomes 0 here. This maximum is 278.3, like this. This also, this distance also you can find here, that is 202.5 divided by 202.5 plus 277.5 into 12, that is 5.0625. so this maximum moment is 0.5 into 202.5 into 5.0625. This is 512.6 kilonewton meter. Here it is minus 450 plus 103 into 4. This is 38 minus 38 here. This is the BMD and this is the SFT.